District Court today. That's 26th of April 2016, and I've just wandered into town to meet my barrister here without an appointment, but we did put something in that email to him. You'll see it online tonight. Email I sent him, and the details for this court hearing that's coming up on the 8th here in this courthouse. Just an update for you people watching, that I've just had a meeting here with my barrister, Shannon Withers, from Vulcan Chambers in Vulcan Lane, in Auckland Central City, New Zealand. Now, the latest is this. I'll keep my followers watching this in form, as well as I'm hoping the British military is watching this video. This one's for you and for the Navy, the British Navy, that I've just spoken to my barrister and conveyed to him my instructions, and also a feedback from him to my police disclosure. You see, they won't give it to me. Full disclosure of Natalie Flower Dew Brown, CIB detective. Now, the latest is he's going to speak to the court to bring her back here from Solomon Islands to face me in court. That's what I asked for. And to tell me why she did what she did, through the barrister, of course. I'm just following the court, otherwise I would say things myself. So what I'm going to do is this. I'm going to set up the court hearing as if I'm the judge, and then put it online, in their words, in their court sense of the word, acts of the latest criminal or Crimes Act 1961, where she's broken the law clearly, and I haven't broken any laws. So for Cook Street, I'm still going to take Cook Street, because now I have a weight of evidence behind me with the native assessors and the King's Bench Court. From our point of view of being native, checks and balances on these lands that still belong to us. Okay. I've just told them that I now the recognised, the mandated King's Bench Court sheriff in the Waitangi Marae King's Bench Court as the native assessor to determine what happens on our lands. That's behind me now. I'm 39 Marae's elders and their chiefs are supporting what I'm saying. They want their land back too. Kingi Taurua, the chief, signed documents that you'll see, the full page that I gave to Shannon Withers to read. He's coming up to speed with it. I'm giving him a bit of time. I said to him that this court case of police interference, tampering with my information, has cost me time to stop my business of land confiscations, exactly the same way as they confiscated our lands. We're doing it legally now through the Waitangi Marae as the prevailing court and law when all else fails. When the law is in conflict with the parliamentary, New Zealand parliamentary law is in conflict with the native law, the native law prevails. And our law is still connected through King William to Westminster Parliament. As 1835 Constitution, 1852 Constitution, UK, Britain, is still on our contract with the Navy in Britain, and the titles of holding now with my barrister, given him all those today, and I'll put all that on my Facebook sites, my YouTube. I'll make a video when I get home of our meeting today. So I had to ring the police to let them know I'm coming into town, because told him I want the court case dropped because the weight of my evidence is just too much for anyone to refute, because I'm holding the titles to these lands. And there's fraud, I told him, of John Key as being tied up in the Panama tax havens here that I'm now handling, and he's got to come up to speed with what I've written to him in the four-page letter that is holding the evidence of fraud in the government's part on our lands. That's what the offence is. And further to that, I want him to tell the judge to just drop the case. I will deal with it in another court hearing. And at the present time, I'm dealing with things in the highest court in the land, which is the Waitangi Marae Treaty Grounds. And I can go in there with the chiefs anytime I want and have that court hearing. We had a court hearing in there for John Key to put him in court with the charges on the number, case number, that the police in 2009 were going to charge him for treason in opening the Supreme Court of New Zealand. So I told Shannon Withers that the court has no seal, the police have no seal, and the government has no seal, the parliament has no seal of a statement of confidence from Britain and the Queen of England, or Queen of Britain, New Zealand. So we have our statement of confidence in our flag, the 1835 Declaration of Independence flag, and in its sense, 1834, 10th of March, is when the first mortgage was set on Russell, Kororareka, on Mikey Hill, on top with the flag of the Navy, okay? So that's about all I wanted to say. I'm happy. But the case won't be going ahead on the 8th of May 2016. It will be extended for a bit more time. You see how important this case is. When the judge first said that it's a relatively easy case, no, it's not. And my lawyer, my barrister, said, no, John's got a land issue. So those people on Cook Street, there's 40 of you all together, have tampered with my information. You get the bill. That's all I'm doing from the Marae up in Waitangi with all those chiefs. All the chiefs, the old people, are following what I'm saying because it makes sense that they have been duped out by John Key trying to threaten our flag that's got him on these lands in the first place. So here I am in Auckland District Court. Hopped on a train and came in town to see my barrister, and the only way to see him is just to stand in the court and ask somebody, where is he? You see, so that was how I got to see him today, and the office said he's in court. So I went down to the court and found him, no trouble. But on top of that, he has a lot of reading to do. He has those videos to watch that I put on. I put just the videos that mattered, just the proof of the evidence that in the High Court of Admiralty in London, they'll take it straight away. Now we could go straight there and end all of this because it's just fraud all over it. And those people in Cook Street, you better be right on your guard, because I haven't finished my job. I'll set out to do to go and take that land back, because it's not yours now. Belongs to me and my chiefs. And that goes for the treaty grounds and Waitangi land blocks and Te Ti land blocks. Those will be returned to Kingi because I'm setting up the documents. I've got the original one house title of Utatonga, which is my family, the Uataha chief and the Uapohatu, Hikarangi, Mount Hikarangi, and the Marae there, the Marangaroa Marae and Te Araroa, and also the Hiruharama Marae in Rotorua. So those are the titles inside that Marae with the carvings, all the carvings you see in the treaty house, that's my title. And the Marae statues standing in London, that's my title. Okay, to my family in East Island and Raiatea Island and here. And that means Tainui, Ngāti Porou and Ngāpuhi are just brothers in the same Māori statute. So all our titles are Māori, not Māori. The Māori belongs to the Crown and John Key. Okay, so one more time. I'm here in Auckland Central City Courthouse. I just make my way home and then I'll do the rest of the videos there on just what happened today. But Shannon Withers is in Court 3 here, just next door. And caught him in the East break, and I'm very happy about that. So we will see you later, and I'll take a couple of shots on the way home. Thank you very much. Bye. John Wanoa, Auckland Central City.